I'm Logan and I'm a painter. I've been receiving the compliment of fine artist lately, but I've spent years looking for that title because as a kid, I would draw all the time and people would be like, oh, one day you're going to be a famous artist. But no one had the definition or course I should take to get to that point. And I always thought it sounded nice, but never knew what it meant. So I probably started off thinking I'd be a tattoo artist. Then years later, I thought I'd be an illustrator, maybe like a comic book writer or something. Fast forward, I thought maybe street art was the thing. And I think fine art, the title of fine art came after the culmination of all those. Like now that I mix everything I've learned from back then to now, it's giving a fine art energy, but I'm still not sure. I would call it experimental though. And that's why it's hard to define. I get asked that a lot, like what style is this or what do you call it? And to this day, I've been working on it forever, but to this day it's just experimental. But it's also expressionist. And soon I hope to step into something that's characterized as surrealistic. You know, like it'll probably never just be that, but I got my eyes on a lot of surrealist ideas. I hop around between watercolor, oil, acrylic, aerosols, and I mean, I've done textile work. Whatever there is, if I find out about it, I'm gonna try it. Picasso, Dali, Frida. I like Frida because she paints herself a lot. And when I got into painting myself for the sake of like reflection, I was met with a lot of criticism. But looking at her art helped me just say, fuck it. Like, paint what you want, you know? I think the drive behind it is figuring out what the drive behind it is. I'm always asking that question. I guess it's just personal interest. But sometimes it's not. Sometimes it's, I'll paint something that I hate. And sometimes I feel like I get an answer, but it usually just leads to more questions. And all those questions equal, you know, pursuit. So it's a pursuit. And if I could paint every day, always, it's a good day every day. But sometimes, you know, can't paint every day. The age of 3 always comes to mind first. I was probably in daycare drawing animals and dinosaurs. There was this one time that I had drawn an iguana. Oh, I might have been like in the second grade. I drew it in class and I brought it home to my dad. And I was like, look, Dad, I drew this. And he was like, no, you didn't. And I was like, yeah. And he was like, no. And we had this back and forth. And then he was like, who'd you steal this from? And I had to draw more things in front of him for him to believe that I drew it. I was like, okay, that was weird. And another occasion, I had gone on vacation with my family to Belize, and we had hopped off the boat to go to like a small island just to chill. And right before I left, I had drawn a shark in the sand, like really big with my foot. And when we get back on the boat, I turned around and like looked over at the beach, and there was like a crowd of like 50 people around the shark. And that was probably the first moment where I was like, whoa, like there's something to this. From when I started to about the age of 18, everyone was like, oh, cool, this is amazing, you're great. But then when I turned 18, everyone who supported me, like parents, friends, teachers, they kind of switched up. They were like, okay, now you have to find something practical and lucrative to do. And I was like, well, what happened to being an artist? And the usual message was, well, that's fine, that's a nice hobby, but it's not going to pay enough. Or yeah, usually it's not going to pay enough. So I mean, I had maybe two jobs in between being an artist, but being an artist always called to me, so I left those jobs really quickly and kept at it. Making it a career, it's been about six, seven years. But yeah, like I said, when I was 18, it became like career or not. I feel like I've always been doing it. This is probably like the largest version of an idea that came about in 2019. The idea was, it was about America. It was just a small sketch of two guys sitting at a table having some drinks and they're smiling at each other exaggeratedly, and they're pointing guns at each other under the table, and it's like very American to me because America's all about flexing and making money and business and power and, you know, getting what you want by any means. America's a very narcissistic place, and America loves guns. It has been a processing of emotions. I think without art, I'd be in a bad place. And maybe that's where a lot of people are, like when they don't have an outlet. And that's what a lot of it is. It's a lot of time to process what I'm going through, what I'm thinking about. And sometimes it's just fun, you know? But a lot of times it's not. I feel like as I get older, there's a lot of pressure for it to not be fun. There's a lot of external force that requires me to be something or do things that aren't natural to me. And the art comes in when I ignore all that and just keep on course. I hope, you know, once I'm gone or, you know, years from now, I'll be that person that a kid looks at for guidance. Because like I said, back then when people were telling me you're going to do this when you're older, I didn't know where to go. I didn't know what to look for reference until I was like 20. So whenever that time comes for somebody else, I hope they can look for me for reference.
Signal what's up, you know? Or someone has to touch it. It has to be demonstrated. It's sturdy, too. It's like over 10 years old, and it's like made of paper or something, but it's like, tough.
And it's thick.